Hey everybody, Krista Kitsune here, and today is the first day of fall. So happy first day of fall, everybody. Yes, today is the 22nd of, well for you, of September, and I mean, I'm recording this a day early, so it's actually the 21st right now, but for you, it's the 22nd. And I'm big, so that means something's gonna be going down involving food. More than likely. Usually when I'm big like this, the window's big, it means that I'm eating something, so you can see the food and stuff that I eat better than the little tiny, you know, thing in the corner over here usually. So, in celebration, I guess you could say, of the first day of fall, I went and got a bunch of pumpkin related stuff. Most of the things here are pumpkin spice. But there are different iterations of the pumpkin spice. The only thing that's not pumpkin spice is this and that. I was also going to they had pumpkin spice Rice Krispie treats. And I would have gotten those, except for they were just selling them in a box of 40. And I've never tried pumpkin spice flavored, you know, Rice Krispie treats before, so I didn't want to pay $8 for a box of 40 in case I didn't like them. I could have made them myself, but I was so busy today that I just completely forgot about it, and I didn't make them, because I actually have the stuff to make them. I got the butter, I got the marshmallow, and the Rice Krispies, and I completely forgot about that. So instead, I just got 5 eating things and 1 drinky thing, and that's pumpkin spice. Okay, so the one thing that's not pumpkin spice is this. And these are actually Little Debbie Pumpkin Delights, and they're cookies with pumpkin in them. And you can see, like, they look like little jack-o'-lanterns. They've got little faces on them. So that's the first thing. The other thing is these things here, they're called Little Bites. They're muffins, essentially. Or not muffins. Yeah, muffins. And they are pumpkin muffins. So they're not actually pumpkin spice, they're just pumpkin flavored. So, there's that. I think they would still be pumpkin spicy to make them taste kind of like pumpkin pie, maybe. I also got this big ass box of pumpkin spice life cereal, limited edition, and I have a bowl with a spoon, an orange bowl even, so it matches everything, and some milk, some of my lactose free milk. So we'll try that last because it involves like a 2-part type thing. The other thing that I have some Keebler fudge-striped pumpkin spice cookies, and I got some pumpkin spice wafers. Well, these are like heavy as fuck, but pumpkin spice wafers. So we'll go ahead and start with, I guess, the non-pumpkin spice things first, which is the cookies and the muffins, and then we'll have the fudge stripes, the wafers, and then the last thing that we'll eat is the cereal. Oh, the drink that I have is a limited edition Starbucks pumpkin spice latte in a bottle. It's like a bottle of pumpkin spice latte. So we'll have that to drink. And stupid focus. Quit. It's supposed to be autofocus, but it doesn't autofocus very well. So here's a little itty bitty cookie. It doesn't really have a face. It has a mouth. But it doesn't really have eyes. The eyes are like way the fuck up there. They're just all like dish. They look like dish. But it can smell like the pumpkin even through the packaging. Yep, that smells like pumpkin, alright. I remember a few years back now, I made pumpkin pie from scratch. I also made pumpkin bread from scratch. Not the funnest thing to do, to get pumpkin to be edible. Nice and moist. I like chewy cookies better than hard cookies. Not too bad. Just more of the pumpkin gooiness. I mean, contrary to belief, you would think that it was kind of filled with the pumpkin stuff and just like top was like flopped over. But no, apparently that's just like just a part to make a face. It's not all the way through. I'll give those a 8.5, 8.5. And since I have this, I'll go ahead and try some of it to help wash down all these cookies. They make these things so hard to get into because of all the people out there these days that are like, if they don't put seals and stuff on them, people will open the thing or put poison in or some stupid thing like that. Make it difficult for people to get into. I mean, if you think it's hard for me to get into, like, just imagine how hard it would be for, like, an elderly person to get into. I don't know if that's still the pumpkin cookie I'm tasting. I don't think so. Not too bad. It's coffee, but it's pumpkin pie flavored. Or pumpkin spice flavored. Not too bad on the pumpkin latte. I guess we'll go ahead and try these puppies. See, each company does pumpkin spice differently. So Little Debbie made cookie pumpkin cookies. These are technically pumpkin cookies also, but they're just like fudge dipped or fudge striped or whatever. Pumpkin cookies with like white frosting. These ones don't really taste as pumpkin-y as these ones, the first ones. They taste more like, just like kind of like cinnamon cookies with frosting on them. Well, all these flavors are gonna run together and I'm gonna like end up not tasting things correctly. I should actually not wash my, stuff off with pumpkin flavored stuff. I was actually gonna eat these next and I forgot. I'm sorry. But I was gonna eat these next and then go for the fudge stripes or the, and then the wafers, but it happens. Like I said, I was busy today, so my mind isn't quite here. I had to clean a bathroom, which is super fun, not. And then I had to help my mom mow the lawn, because we got a new lawnmower and she needed my help filling it up and stuff because we haven't filled it up yet. So we got these little muffins, little pumpkin muffins. They're itty bitty. I used to eat the shit out of like the blueberry flavored ones. I remember getting these little bites. They're by Entenmann's. I remember getting these little packages like in my school lunch and stuff, and they were just these little muffins, and you just, you know, eat them. There's not that very many in there. I think like 4 in a package. I think they gave you more before, but now there's only 4. I guess since there's not actually supposed to be spice on these ones taste the least like pumpkin. And at least these cookies, the fudge stripes, they have like cinnamon or something in them. These ones have like barely any cinnamon. They're kind of bland. They're soft and moist, so I give them that. But they're like really, I guess they have like a touch of a pumpkin flavor, but it's mostly like a little bit of pumpkin and a little bit of spice, and that's these. So pumpkin cookies, these ones here, even though they're not supposed to be like pumpkin spice, these ones like smelled and tasted like pumpkin like right off the bat. These ones here, the fudge stripes, they taste like cinnamon and like graham, like cinnamon graham crackers kind of, with stripes on them. So, out of all of them so far, the only ones that actually really taste like pumpkin are the Little Debbies. These ones I have high hopes for because it says it's baked with real pumpkin. I never heard of Voortman's before, but they have like a whole bunch of different flavors, like vanilla and chocolate and these ones. So I figured, hey, why not try them? The only thing I don't like about wafers is that they're super messy. Like, even if you take a bite out of one of them and like this whole wafer stuff on the outside breaks off and then it kind of makes a mess over everything. Especially like the strawberry ones because I got excuse me. I got like strawberry wafers, which are like bright pink. So when you're eating them and they get dust all over the place, there's like hot pink dust, like almost as bad as Cheeto dust, hot orange dust. So here's the wafer. These ones taste kind of almost like the first ones, only in wafer form. There's stuff in between the wafer is the pumpkin sauce. And these ones taste more like the first ones, but there's got the wafer on the outside, so it's more crispy. So those aren't too bad. Okay, so the last thing that we'll get to do is the cereal. We get to do the cereal. And if I don't like this, I'm stuck with a whole bunch of cereal. So I bought a bowl and a spoon. And I'll pour some of this into the small bowl. I won't put a lot in here, just enough to try it out. And then pour a little milk, my lactose-free milk, into it. And cleanse the palate with milk, because everything else tastes like pumpkin, so I got the pumpkin flavor in my mouth. Okay, so here is the pumpkin flavored cereal, Life cereal. Well, this cereal is like the least flavored thing. So I guess in terms of flavor, I mean excluding the drink the latte. Okay, so the cereal doesn't taste it tastes cinnamony more than anything. It doesn't taste like pumpkin. So that's a zero. I'll give the Little Bites. They have a slight pumpkin flavor, a slight like spicy type thing, like very little. I'll give those like a four. The fudge stripes, the fudge stripes, I'll give like a six. Then the wafers, a 7.5, and then the pumpkin delights. The pumpkin delights the first thing that we ate, like 9.5, 8.5 to 9. Excuse me. Like one of these things didn't agree with me. Like it making me all catch in my throat. So that's going to be a very short video. I would have had more if I could have found more, but and then I would have made the Rice Krispie Treats, which would have been an extra thing, but totally forgot to do that, so I apologize. This video will be somewhat short. Excuse me, now I'm all burpy. Also, some interesting news. It took me, or took Snack Crate 2.5 weeks to get my Snack Crate to me. August. And I canceled my subscription to them shortly, after the 2 week period because this is like ridiculous. Finally, they delivered it, and then I was able to do the snack crate last Friday. Just a couple days ago, actually, I think it was yesterday. I get an email from them saying that my snack crate has shipped, and I'm thinking like, what? And apparently, I don't know how they, why or why it was so early, but they shipped my snack crate, and I have it already. So I'm thinking, hopefully, that's September's snack crate, not just a repeat of August because they thought that I didn't get it or something. But anyway, so I did get another snack crate box, so I'll be doing that one here. For next Friday, this is sitting in the refrigerator, should be fine. There's usually not anything perishable in there. It's just like stale stuff that could go stale. So I got that to look forward to next Friday, and then I'll be looking for another snack crate type thing here in the future. So either I don't know. I know there's at least two other ones that I could check out. So I'm gonna go ahead and end the video here because my voice is starting to go and I'm coughing way too much. So I'm gonna say thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give a like, share with your friends, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff. There's a Discord you can get into now. Just click the link on the bottom and it'll take you to the Discord. If you go over in this section, there'll be a video that YouTube suggests you check out. Here in the middle will be my face. You can click on that to go subscribe. And over here in this section right in here will be a link to the merchandise store where you can go get some merch, a t-shirt or a tote bag with my mascot on it. The mascot that you see right there. Just not that particular picture, but a picture nonetheless similar to that for t-shirt wear or a tote bag. And yeah, so that was the first day of fall celebration, even though it's not really a celebration that anybody celebrates. It's just I like fall more than winter, winter or summer. So happy fall. And soon we'll be falling back and getting another extra hour for daylight savings time. So there's that. So anyway, thanks so much for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.